Hello, this is Radar Lacroix. Today I'm going to be talking about, I guess I'm just going to be doing some more myth busting about Christianity, because it seems like a lot of people have a lot of misconceptions. I always want to say misconceptions about Christianity. And I'll go ahead and I'll point out why, first of all. Well, first of all, it's because a lot of people are not living by how Jesus told them to live. The people that make you dislike Christians are the ones that try to shove it down your throat, the ones that judge you based on your life, the ones that think that they're allowed to mistreat any kind of person for any kind of reason that they can come up with. You know, basically, if you've watched any of my other videos where I read from the Bible, like, you will... The theme is very obvious from the section, you know, that Jesus just wants you to accept everybody. Jesus just wants you to be nice to everyone, be nice to each other. Like, I literally, problem is like, he says so much stuff and I've been skipping around through everything because I'm like, oh, this is really good, that's really good, this is really good. But he even says, you are the salt of the earth. And let me explain what that means, because people don't understand. Being the salt of the earth basically means you give life flavor. You make life bearable for other people. You are the salt of the earth. So you have to be that person who turns the other cheek and makes life bearable and isn't always complaining and isn't always, you know, making everything about you and isn't always, you know, like trying to make other people feel bad because, you know, your life's not perfect and everyone's not trying to make your life perfect. And, you know, those people who are just constantly dissatisfied with life. And my thing is I am constantly dissatisfied, but I separate it where I'm like, there's an important concept of like when, and if you watch Julia Christina, who is a registered clinical therapist on YouTube, you might be acquainted with this idea. If you don't, you should watch her videos. Once again, that's Julia Christina, registered clinical therapist. Very good videos to watch if you're interested. But it's the idea of, if I have a problem, I have a problem. The other person obviously doesn't think that what they've done or what's going on is a problem. Obviously, they don't think it's a problem because they're doing it. It's not a problem for them. It's a problem for me. So it's my responsibility to deal with it and say something in a respectful way. And that's something else that I've realized. People don't like that. And that is why people who call themselves Christians are really poor Christians, because this is something that I do not know why humanity is so wrapped around this. I get wrapped up in this. I have to like literally pull myself away. So I don't understand why I'm like this. I don't understand why other people are like this. We are so attached to being upset. We are so attached, super glued ourselves. Like, this is us. This is being upset about something or offended. Always humanity is like this for some reason. Me included. Like, me, the person who is like, and I'm not saying, you know, oh, everyone just stop being offended as a code word or code phrase for we shouldn't have to, you know, respect people's triggers and respect people's mental illnesses. Like, no, you have to respect people's triggers and respect people's mental illnesses. But we all should just try not to get so offended all the time. And yeah, no, I don't mean offended as in triggered. That's not what that word means. You know, I mean people who get offended who... they're not even trying. And before you like try to get in with this, I'm going to get in with it myself. No, you will not be able to tell when people are trying or not. Okay? You cannot go into someone's mind and look in someone's brain and be like, "Oh, you're trying or you're not trying." You know, you can't just tell by how it looks. Like, that's why I get so depressed in my life, is because for me and because of my mental illness, genuinely certain things that deal with emotions and certain things in life are really hard for me. And it looks like I'm not even trying, because that is how hard it is. That is how difficult it is. Like, you know, it's like those advertisements where, you know, they don't say that they're for people with different abilities, or what would maybe be called a disability in old terms, but people who are alternately abled, you know, where people are throwing around their stuff, you know, normally abled people are on these advertisements, just throwing stuff around, looking ridiculous. But then when someone points out, well, it's because a lot of these products are for people with disabilities or for people who are alternatively abled, then you go, oh, duh. Like, that's how I look. You'll look at me like, what is wrong with this chick? Like, she did not know how to be. That's because I literally have a mental illness. Like, it's really hard for me. And yes, I'm trying. I'm trying super hard. But it's still difficult. You know, and that's why we say that it impacts our lives. And that's why we say that it affects us so much. Because other people will simultaneously say, no, it doesn't affect you. Why can't you do this thing? And you're like, I can't do the thing because I'm being affected. That's why. No, you're not being affected. Why can't you do the thing? Like, but, you know, and that is kind of, and I love how I have to go in and explain in detail what I'm not talking about. That's what I'm not talking about in terms of, like, people who can't control their emotions and their anger. I am, like, okay, if you saw my No One Thing video, I separate people who have poor emotional regulation skills from people who are mentally ill. I'm talking about people with poor emotional regulation skills, okay? Those are the people who give Christianity a bad name. And that's why it kind of upsets me so much, is because true Christians, and I have encountered a lot of them, you probably, like, I would say that you wouldn't even know they're Christian, but the only reason you wouldn't know is because they're not constantly spewing it out of their mouth. They're acting it out. But here's the thing. They act it out so well, you can tell they're Christian. When you come into contact, like when you read what Jesus says, how to live, and I'm looking at these people, and I can think of their names to call to mind, but I won't, obviously, because, you know, this is a random video. But I'm like, wow, they are doing it. They are killing it here. Like, and they are good people. And I'm not, you know, I'm not, like, justifying. I'm talking about, like, if you met them, no matter who you are, you probably would like these people. Like, and agree that they're nice people. And even if you don't think that they're the most super interesting, awesome, crazy, interesting people in the world, like, you're still like, wow, they're super nice. Like, those people who aren't so nice that they're creepy, they're so nice that you wish you could be that nice. And how are they so nice? Like, those are real Christians, okay? Like you, there will be no mystery about it. You will not wonder whether or not they like you or accept you. They just will. Like, and there are people who try, you know, people who have their own lot in life. And that's why another concept for you is, I'm like, when people are all like, oh, Christians are bad because, excuse my stomach is growling. People are like, oh, Christians are bad because they need someone to tell them, you know, what to do that's right. But I'm like, no offense, like, Jesus, you know, coming to the earth and walking around and seeing everything that people are doing and, like, calling out every single thing, like, you would 100% agree with everything he says. Like, and that's where I kind of come to the point where I'm like, people who hate Christians must be, like, religiously biased. Like, to me, if you hate someone because they say they're a Christian just for that reason and you don't know anything else about them, you haven't spoke to them in any other way, if you reject people just because they're Christian, like, that makes you kind of a horrible person. And by Christian standards, also, that kind of makes you a horrible person. You know, Jesus said, measure others as you would want it to be measured to you. And for me, like, the Bible, I literally have it open right here. I can read it to you. Oh, geez. The nations and kingdoms of the earth will rise against each other, and there will be famines and earthquakes in many places, where the Sermon on the Mount of Olives, Matthew 24, verse 4. But all this will be only the beginning of the horrors to come. Then you will be tortured and killed and hated all over the world because you are mine. And many of you shall fall back into sin and betray and hate each other. And many false prophets will appear and lead many astray. Sin will be rampant everywhere and will cool the love of many. But those enduring it to the end shall be saved. So, Jesus said, he knew it was all going to happen. Okay, Jesus is basically calling out all those people who hate Christians just because they're Christian. He literally says, they will hate you just because you're mine, not for any other reason. And I know all of a sudden everyone's going to be like, oh, the persecuted Christians. Oh, here's the persecuted Christians. Be like, okay, first of all, calm all the way down. I will inform you that I am a Hindu pagan who also worships Jesus Christ as an avatar of God. Okay. But here's my thing. I've read the Bhagavad Gita. I've read the Upanishads. I've read the Tibetan Book of the Dead. I've read the Bible, you know. And by the way, the Tibetan Book of the Dead is a Buddhist book, which is closely related to Hinduism. And also, all people who probably don't know this, there are actually a big amount of ideas in Hinduism that are literally copy-paste onto Christianity. Copy-paste. I love how Christians are like, oh, we worship one God, but it's actually three in one. And then all the Hindu gods are over here like, okay, all right, yeah, you worship three different gods, but they're actually one God. But I'm like, you want to know what Hinduism is? Hinduism is that you worship thousands of gods and spirits, but they're all one God. Which, you know, and then Christianity is like, God is in everything. I'm like, Hinduism, see the Lord in every creature. Like, you know, there are so many things that are so similar that's the other thing I don't understand. Hindus and Christians, why y'all hate each other? What, just because some people are bad at being Christian, you're like, ugh, hate all Christians. And just because some people are bad at being Hindu, you're like, ugh, hate all Hindus. Like, really, people? Like, that would be like me going outside, seeing a horse, and being like, that's the worst duck ever. Like, you know, and like, I can go outside and I can say to someone, I'm a duck. I am. I believe I'm a duck. But like, unless I have webbed feet, unless I quack, like, am I really a real duck? You know? And I also want to say, because I know that some people are going to try to like make that into a weird gender thing. Let me tell you something. Gender is an idea. So is religion. So if your thoughts are aligned with your religion, you are that religion. If your thoughts and actions are aligned with that religion, if your thoughts and actions are aligned with your gender and you believe you are what you are and you carry it out, like, and you want to know what else I think? I think that that's a stupid comparison to make. You want to know why? Because what somebody's gender is doesn't actually affect you. How someone expresses who they are doesn't actually affect you. So don't try to make that into a, don't try to twist around my words, just like all of you try to twist around Jesus's words in here. You know, that's what I hate, is someone asks Jesus a question, Jesus answers it, and everyone's like, oh, well, he could be talking about this. I'm like, well, y'all asked about this, so is he talking about this or that? Probably the thing you asked about. So don't try to turn it into he's talking about something that you didn't even ask about, okay, or that the Pharisees didn't even ask about. And here's the other thing. If you're going to go around picking apart every single thing Jesus says when he tells you, love God, be kind to each other, everything hangs on these, and you're going to be trying to pick through and find reasons to be angry at people, find reasons to be mean to people, like, forget you. Like, that's not what it's about. Like, you're as bad as the Pharisees now because you are literally following Jesus around trying to wait for him to give you permission to be a bad person, you know? Like, you're waiting for Jesus to give you permission to nail him up on the cross. Like, just be a nice person, you know? Like, just be kind and, like, considerate. Be the salt of the earth. And so, in a way, I do understand why people feel this way about Christians. I hesitate to call them that because they don't even act Christian, you know, or Christ-like in any way. Like, that's the thing that I don't understand, is I'm like, oh, you have to act like Christ. I'm like, when was the last time y'all even read, you know, Matthew, Mark, and Luke? When was the last time y'all read it? And I'm sorry, did y'all skip ahead to John the Apostle, who lived 65 to 70 years after his death, or 90 to 100 years after his death. I'm like, no. I'm like, and reading his red letter that he supposedly got from Jesus, I'm like, no. What you need to do is you need to read the accounts that are, and this is what some people don't know. Matthew, Mark, and Luke are basically almost verbatim the same. They are three different people taking accounts of what Jesus is saying. So in there, there are small, minuscule, like one line will be omitted or added, like throughout entire 5 or 6 chapters. But other than that, almost all the stories are completely the same. So I have a lot more faith in that, in that Jesus did these things. Jesus said these things. There are literally three sections over of different people, who supposedly heard what Jesus said. And I believe that a lot more than I believe literally any other thing written in this entire book. And what is important to say is that for the prophesying aspect, Jesus does say that what happened, well, what's funny too is actually he says it in this translation, but I've read other translations, and that's another important thing is you have to read more than one translation of the Bible, because guess what? I have read translations of Hindu scripture by non-Hindu people, and having it actually translated by a practicing Hindu makes all the difference in the world. So you have to remember who, even people who translate this stuff, their biases get carried over into it, because guess what? They want a permission to be mean. They want permission to just be mean to somebody. So this is my video telling you, no, you don't have permission to be mean to people. Christians who are mean to you are not good Christians. But you can't just stay mad at them forever, because we're supposed to forgive each other and move past it. No, you don't have to stay around anyone who's violent. You know, it's kind of, it's funny, because I feel like people read the words of God and the words of Jesus, and they're like, oh, all this stuff is obvious. You know, love your brother, meek on earth, the earth. Yeah, people who take advantage of you suck. But I'm like, but then why? And even Jesus even says that. He's like, so you agree with me? Why do you keep doing all that other stuff then? But what's funny is what it comes down to is when people came to Jesus, you want to know what he did? He didn't sit there. He said, you all will be judged someday. He came to save people. Came to save people. And all he really asked of people was that they believe in him. And you want to know, when Jesus was young, and the other children were watching him play, and they saw him bring his clay figures to life, they thought he was a witch, and their mothers told them not to play with him. And then you want to know, all through his life, people were trying to convince him that he was evil, and he was bad, and he was doing things in the name of the devil, even though he was healing people, casting out demons. And even when his disciples came to him and said, these other people are casting out demons in your name, but they're not with us, so we told them to stop. And he said, anyone who's not against us is with us. Let them cast out demons. So really, Jesus is just like, I don't really care how you do it. Just be nice to each other. Just be kind, But no, and then, so people just following him around his whole life, trying to seem like he's evil or whatever. But then when someone comes to him and they're begging him, please, Jesus, please, help my child. Please, I need you. I need your help. And he even says to some of these people, he says to one woman, I shouldn't be giving, the food for my children to dogs, because she was more wealthy, a wealthier woman. And she said, please, master, even the dogs eat the crumbs that the children drop. And he said, your faith has saved you. And he healed the woman's child, or what she had asked, and granted that woman, her prayer. All he asks is that you believe that he can heal you. Honestly, I believe in my heart that all God wants from us is for us to love God enough to love each other and to see God in each other, to see that good in that merciful side to everyone and to exercise our own merciful side. Because that is why people love Jesus so much, because he was merciful and he was kind. I don't care what anyone else says. You know, Jesus says that those who love much forgive much, and Jesus forgave everyone who believed in him. I don't think there was anyone who asked Jesus for help and he turned them away. The people who didn't get help didn't ask for it. So that's me just kind of trying to show you, don't hate Christians, okay? Because the people who treat you badly and call themselves Christians at the same time, they're not what you think they are. Jesus said, you know, people will come calling themselves Christians and prophets, but they're wolves in sheep's clothing, you know? So Jesus even told us to look out for this. So please don't hate other Christians for being really bad at being Christian, because that was kind of why Jesus came in the first place, because Jesus is like, wow, you guys really suck at just existing. And we're all like, yes, please help us, Jesus, you know? So I just hope that kind of clears things up, because, you know, it's been kind of just making me feel sad to watch everybody fight, because I'm like, little do you all know, you're all supposed to love each other, you know? So I just hope that that kind of, you know, sets things on the right path, you know, and don't get all caught up in those people. Just be like, well, you know, maybe you should reread the Bible, because I don't think that's how Jesus wants you to be treating everybody. Jesus says to love God and love your neighbor, and that everything hinges on those. So, all right, I'll talk to you guys later. That was really all I wanted to say. Bye-bye.